What is going on, everybody? Well, wanted to work on the BRX01 from Boom Racing. Still waiting to find a few parts. It's going to take quite a bit to bring all that stuff together. A lot of modifying of parts to make everything work. And still a few parts that I can't find in stock anywhere. But I want to work on something. So we're going to start on this Tamiya Scania R470 Highline 4x2 truck. Had this kit laying around for probably 6 years now. Bought it because I got it really cheap. Anybody who's into this hobby knows these trucks can be $500-$600. I managed to get this one for less than $200, so I bought it. I don't know, not the best looking truck in the world, but you know, what can you do? Done a little bit of the prep work already. We're gonna get the chassis put together. I'll probably kind of just speed that video up, and then I'll run normal speed with the things that I've seen people struggle with in the past, and kind of give you my ideas on it when we get there, mainly the axle and transmission. Pretty basic. I am adding the aluminum steering servo holder because that is one of the issues with these trucks. If you use a high torque servo, you tend to get a lot of twist in the steering servo mounting bracket. I do have a set of Boom Racing ball bearings to replace the little bronze bushings that come with Tamiya kits. Why they do that, I don't know, but it is what it is. Steering servo is a high tech. Get that in there. Hopefully you can see that through the reflection. $35 servo, about 180 inch pounds of torque at 7.4 volts. It's all already been put together there. I did a little pre-work. And the shifting servo is just a cheap Futaba, what is that, S3004 is what I'm using for the shift servo. I think you can pick those up for like $15 or something. I don't know, I've had laying around forever. And it's very weak, so I figured it would work for the shifting servo. We'll jump right ahead. All that's done. Battery, I got a Traxxas ID, 7.2 volt. Nickel metal hydride. Not looking to put terrible amount of power in this thing, so the nickel metal hydride is fine. And I have a Traxxas ID charger, so I went with the Traxxas ID battery. Really makes charging batteries so easy. You do need a little bit of thread lock, and of course it comes in the kit. They have a little tube of it. And grease comes in the kit too, but I'll be using my regular Vanquish marine grease. Stuff that comes in the kit, I don't know, it kind of tends to dry out over time. And unless you run into a problem, this isn't one of those kits where you're taking things apart a lot for maintenance. At least not been my experience anyway. But anyway, we're going to crack on. Like I said, I'll probably just speed up the video of the basic frame going together. There are a few other prep things I did. This bracket, you can see those two little press-in nuts there on the back, on the inside of it. And all you do is take a M3 screw with a washer, put it on there, put the little nut on there, and crank it down until it pulls that little press nut into the plastic. Takes quite a bit of cranking to get them pulled in there, but once you get them in there, they stay. So, and then this little cross member has two M3 lock nuts that you kind of press in. They press in fairly easy. You can press them in with your fingers, but they do stay in there. And that's where I believe, I hadn't looked ahead quite that far in the instructions, but I believe that's where your rear axle mounts through the frame into those lock nuts. So we will crack on And of course, anybody that's ever built a Tamiya kit knows that you get big bags full of screws and a bunch of sprues full of plastic, and you gotta hunt around and find all of these doodads and doohickeys and all that other stuff. As they say in Great Britain, all these bits and bobs. Putting one of these together can be overwhelming if you've never built an RC before, particularly a Tamiya. Tamiya has their way of doing things. It's different from everybody else. It works. But it does, you do have to really pay attention to what's going on to find everything. Pulling, just for this step here, putting this chassis together, I was pulling parts from like 5 different sprues. So, like I said, if you're patient, you know, you can get it. But anyway, we'll crack on and get this part put together. And go from there. And I mean, if I find the stuff I need for the BRX01, you know, I'll definitely get started on that, and maybe I'll kind of have both of them going at the same time. Hopefully it won't take that much longer to people to get things back in stock. So anyway, let's crack on. And there it is. I get to mess with all these wires and alright. Now of course, this being Tamiya, everything fits together just like it's supposed to. I don't ever recall having a problem with one of their kits having fit problems or missing parts or anything like that. But anyway, there's a basic chassis. One thing I did do is I wanted to take the shine off of some of the plastic. So I did take some 1500 grit wet or dry sandpaper, a little bit of soapy water, sanded the aluminum frame rails, and sanded all the plastic a little bit just to get some of the shine off of it. Kind of help lose the plastic look a little bit without having to go through and paint everything. There's the basic chassis. Everything fits together, goes together like it's supposed to. Little fiddly getting all this on up here. You can see the leaf springs for the front axle. You got three parts together there. A little plastic spacer, two metal parts, and then the plastic piece on the back that you run your screws into. And of course, this is Tamiya, so that means break out the Phillips screwdrivers. I think there's actually a kit available for these trucks that replaces everything with Allen head. But why go through that expense? That thing kit probably like $40 or something like that. I don't know. I've seen them, but I never really paid that much attention to them. But there it is. Here's our shift servo hanging out down here on the bottom. Our steering servo. Which there's a lot going on there. Which most of the problem the people have with the steering servo, if they're using a higher torque servo, this aluminum bracket that I use, this aftermarket bracket, it's made by Tamiya. That plastic bracket, if you have a high torque servo, that plastic bracket tends to twist and move. And you kind of lose a little bit of your steering. But with the aluminum bracket, it's not going anywhere. So that should help. This little arm here that connects the servo to the... probably a better way to do that, but I guess it'll work. With the bearings in there, it's pretty smooth. It's stiff enough, it's not going anywhere, so hopefully just the aluminum bracket will do the job. So that'll do it this time around. Next time around, we'll get the front axle together, get that mounted up. A lot of little bits and bobs in that too. These trucks they're pretty nice. They're expensive kits, unless you can find them for a steal like I did. But they're a pretty nice kit. One issue I have, I'll point out next time around, and it's a small issue, but it makes no sense to me why they do it. But anyway, that'll do it this time around. So till next time, later.